Eric met Sheila in 72. When Sheila told Eric a suede affection, she said, "It's hard wearing," he said, "by mistake." And henceforth began their practical game. At the till, Sheila said what they trained her to say when she started the job there, the premium spray. "Can I interest sir in this protective spray?" "Do I need it?" said Eric, objecting. "I don't know," replied Sheila. "Do you need protecting?" Oh, Eric and Sheila would never have caught it. Oh, Sheila and Eric might never have wed if Sheila had not got that part-time job sorted and Eric wore sandals instead. Once united, he wanted a semi-detached, but her dream was a cottage in Cheshire. Eric made sure he contracted piles in advance. 10 days eating croissants, adjusting his pants. "We'll leave them," said Sheila, uncertain of whether to kill him or just close the curtain. Both Eric and Sheila might just have persisted. Though Sheila and Eric may have not pressed a bolt, if Eric could run in his dream unassisted. Instead, she suggested a night of desire, candelabras, martinis in simpy attire. And though Eric's impression of James Bond was there, she still showed him some things he could bite on. Then his filling came out, had to turn the big light on. Sheila walked out one day with altercation. A row about pants does need justification. And Eric just sat there, just watching her go, wondering if he should do something, if he should go. And she went for a bun in her favourite cafe. And he stood in the kitchen and was not in her way. Her relieved, him elated, then a sudden dismay, as they both had the realization, giving up might be worse than the mild irritation of Eric not knowing which cloth was for bathrooms, and Sheila forgetting that he didn't like braid. The shoe sprays and molds and badly made cocktails, the Cluedo and croissants and dreams and mistakes and impractical games. Don't mean you should stop playing. In that moment, they finally agree. It's too late, but they finally agree.